It appears to be magic, but it's actually a simple circuit. Want to know how I made this LED fade in and out without a microcontroller? Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to create a fade in and fade out LED effect using just a 555 timer and a few basic components. Stay tuned to the second part of this video where I'll explain how this circuit works. I've packed my favorite 555 timer projects into a free ebook. Yep, totally free. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 4 jumper wires, 1 100,000 ohm resistor, 1 2,200 ohm resistor, 1 100 ohm resistor, 1 1,000 microfarad capacitor, 1 22 microfarad capacitor, 1 white LED, 1 555 timer IC, a 9 volt battery, a 9 volt battery buckle connector, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Starting from the top left is pin 1, which is ground or the ground supply. Pin 2 is trigger. It is used to start the timing interval in both monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 is output. It delivers the result of the timer's operation based on its mode, either monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4 is reset. It is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 is control. It allows you to control the threshold voltage levels that the internal comparators use to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6 is threshold. It monitors the voltage of the capacitor connected to the circuit. Pin 7 is discharge. It controls the charge and discharge cycle of the timing capacitor. Pin 8 is VCC. It is responsible for supplying the power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Start by placing the 555 timer IC onto the breadboard. Remember, the pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Bend the ends of a 100 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 100 kilo ohm resistor into pin 3 or output and pin 6 or threshold. Insert a 22 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger and the negative rail. The anode is in pin 2. Bend the ends of a 2200 ohm resistor. Insert the 2200 ohm resistor into pin 3 or output and a few rows below the 555 timer. Bend the ends of a 100 ohm resistor. Insert the 100 ohm resistor into the same row as the resistor and a few rows below the resistor. Insert a 1000 microfarad capacitor into the same row as the resistor and the negative rail. The anode is in the same row as the resistor. Insert a white LED into the same row as the 100 ohm resistor and the negative rail. The anode is in the same row as the resistor. Attach the buckle connector to the 9 volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Connect the positive lead of the battery holder to the positive rail. Connect the negative lead of the battery holder to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. Notice how the LED slowly fades in and out. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This is a fade-in and out LED circuit using a 555 timer IC in a stable mode. The purpose of the circuit is to gradually brighten and dim an LED in a smooth, eye-catching loop, often used in visual displays or breathing LED effects. At the core of the circuit is the 555 timer configured as an oscillator, generating a continuous square wave output at pin 3. The timing components, a 100 kilo ohm resistor and a 22 microfarad capacitor, connected to pin 6 or threshold in pin 2, or trigger determine the frequency of the oscillation. The capacitor charges and discharges through the resistor, creating a voltage cycle that makes the 555 output go high and low periodically. When the output at pin 3 goes high, it charges a 1000 microfarad capacitor through a 2200 ohm resistor. This capacitor is connected in parallel with the LED and a 100 ohm current limiting resistor. As the capacitor charges, the voltage across the LED gradually increases, causing the LED to fade in. When the output goes low, the capacitor discharges slowly through the 100 ohm resistor and the LED, causing it to fade out. The result is a smooth and repeating fade-in and fade-out LED effect, controlled by the timing of the 555 timer and the charging-discharging behavior of the large capacitor. The capacitor's large value ensures that the fading happens slowly and visibly, rather than in a rapid flash. This circuit is powered by a 9-volt battery, and pin 4 or reset is tied to pin 8 or VCC to keep the IC active, while pin 5 or control is left unconnected but can be used for further modulation if needed. I hope this video has shown you how to make a fade in and fade out circuit with a 555 timer IC. If you prefer to create a flashing LED effect instead of a fade in and out effect, check out my other video. In this video, the light alternates between the green and red LEDs. There is also a buzzer sound. Want to take it a step further? You can make the flashing speed adjustable by adding a potentiometer. Turn the knob to adjust the speed of the LED blinking. I have linked the videos in the description. Want to dive deeper into 555 timer projects? Grab my free ebook packed with awesome circuits and ideas. Just click the link in the description to download your copy now. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.